The iPad. In 2011, Steve Jobs introduced this tablet device for us. And when I first saw it, I thought to myself, this is going to be the revolution of planning. I traditionally had used paper planners up until the introduction of the iPad to help structure my life. And I navigated to using the iPad moving forward as a digital means of planning. And I can tell you in the first few years, there was a lot of pain and struggle with planning on an iPad until we introduced this guy. The Apple Pencil really changed our capabilities of planning. But since the first generation of the Apple Pencil, we've been able to use iPads in a way that we used paper planners. And now we have a paper-like experience on an iPad. So if you're thinking about digital planning, thinking about an iPad and how this all comes together, today, guys, I'm gonna showcase in this video what type of iPad you should look at, what type of applications you can use for planning, what accessories you wanna consider to really enhance your experience and have a true paper-like feel on your iPad.
And stay around to learn about a 4-in-1 cable by xCool that delivers 100 watts of power. It's our preferred daily carry cable. So that is what we are going to embark on now.
All right, so let's talk about the iPad in general. Since 2011, we've seen generations and generations of iPads. We've seen different sizes, everything from the mini to the Air to the iPad to the Pro. And if you're sitting back and you don't have one in front of you and you go to a store and you start to ask yourself, what is it that I need for planning when it comes to using the iPad? Well, let's talk about that for a little bit. First and foremost, when you think about planning, you have to understand that if it can support an Apple Pencil, if it be generation 1 or generation 2 or even the new generation 3, it is going to be a device that is going to work for planning. It doesn't matter if the device is 6 years old or brand spanking new. If it supports an Apple Pencil, I can trust by telling you it's going to work for you across paper planning. As you start to think about which iPad is going to fit all your needs, there's a couple things to consider. The size of the screen, the storage of the device, and the power of the processor. That's going to help determine what iPad is most meaningful for you. So let's first talk about size. Well, there is an iPad mini. And when you look at the iPad mini and you compare that to, say, the iPad Pro, it is almost twice the size. Where this device is really awesome is if you're looking for something that can fit in your hands, maybe you have a smaller frame, and you want to have a device that fits in your hands for either reading books, browsing the internet, or being able to fit into a confined space, like, for example, a briefcase, a purse. This is a tablet that's really easy to carry with you. And for me, it's something I actually find myself often having just on my desk or at my bedside if I want to take a quick note. But now as I look at a bigger screen, as I look at the iPad 11, you can see from a landscape mode, it's not much bigger than the Pro, but it has more of a letter size paper-like feel. This is a great size when it comes to planning and taking notes because it's traditional in size to a piece of paper. So you can have the same aspect ratio, but really when it comes to like multitasking, so if you're going to have two apps side by side, so I'll open my planner and then I'll pull in another application like my calendar and have those side by side. Now this works really well and it's a great way to like kind of like synchronize your plans from one day to the next, but the screen space is a little bit limited when I start to have multiple apps. Maybe if I wanted to have my photo library or a calculator on this device as well, you can start to see that I start to have limited space. And that's where the Pro really start to give you more capabilities. And that's what I like about the 12-inch, is I can have multiple applications open and I still have a lot of screen space to work with. So think about the size a little bit and think about the space that you're working in, which one feels right for you. The next thing I want to talk about is storage. So any of the planners, no matter what base model storage they come with, they're going to work for digital planning. Digital planning uses very little resources. So don't be caught off guard by if it's 64 megabytes, 128, 256, 512, or a terabyte. That's not going to matter when it comes to planning. But what's going to matter is the ability for you to upgrade that device for additional operating systems in the future, or the number of applications that you're going to install, or the amount of media you're going to consume. So if you take a lot of pictures and you plan on having a lot of video on your iPad, then you're going to want to have something that has more memory. If you see yourself using this for a number of years and you want to be able to have multiple apps, especially high-powered gaming apps that use a lot of storage, then you're going to want to consider higher storage. So when you start to think about what size matters to you when it comes to storage, just think about the number of applications and what you're going to do with it. But any model, no matter what size, if you're strictly looking to use this for planning, it's going to work for you. The last thing let's talk about is power, processing speed. Again, if it supports an Apple Pencil, good chance it has more than enough processing capability for you to do daily planning. But if you're going to be looking at going beyond just daily planning, checking email, and browsing the web, you might want to consider a device that has more power. Now, it doesn't matter if it's the Mini, it's the iPad, it's the Air, or it's the Pro Series. They all have adequate power, but each of them have different capabilities when it comes to processing speed. The Pro is the big dog. It has the most power. Now, we have the M1 and M2 chip and soon M3 chip. Those chips are much faster than their predecessors, and every time a new one comes out, they get faster. And with the Pro models and those additions, you're gonna be able to do a lot of great things with like video editing, editing photos, and even playing some high intense games. But if you don't necessarily look to do that beyond paper planning, then you might want to consider an Air or just an iPad. Those have slower processors, but are still quite capable of consuming tons of media, running apps. Matter of fact, they should still run all the apps. They just not might run them as productive as the Pro model would. So process that and think about what matters most. Ultimately, when you think about the size of the screen, the storage, and the processing power, that's really going to help you determine what your budget is and how much you're going to spend for the device. And maybe if you're in a position where you need to have a budget, you might want to think to yourself, what matters most to me? Is size most important? Well, then look at the size of the device and determine from there. If you have a lower budget, the Air or the Mini might be the best for you. If you have a medium range budget and you want a bigger device, the Air, the iPad, and the Pro might all fit within your budget very well, but you might have to consider the amount of storage you have as well as the amount of processing power. So when it comes to choosing an iPad, there's a lot of options. And by all means, if you have a quick question, jump on our website. We'll be happy to ask you some basic questions to help you through that process. As we get past what iPad we're going to have, then we start to ask ourselves, what applications should we even use when we're doing planning on an iPad? Well, there's two different categories of applications. One is OneNote, and the other is everything else. And everything else consists from PDF annotations like GoodNotes, NoteShelf, and Nobility. And let's talk about the differences. I ask people one common question. Besides the iPad, do you want to synchronize your notes, your planner, with any other devices? And if you say yes, I'm going to ask you what devices. And if you mention an Android device and a Windows device, I'm going to tell you that OneNote would be the best application to use. Because OneNote is a universal application that synchronizes across all those devices. And it has a lot of crazy tools. Beyond just the basic tool being able to write and notate, it also you can type in it, you can highlight in it, and you can even use the lasso tool to copy your notes and move them from one page to the next. And then one of the coolest features that we're able to introduce now with Scribble, and Scribble is a tool that works with the Apple Pencil, is the ability to take those handwritten notes and convert them to text as you are writing. So that's a powerful trait of OneNote. And that will then synchronize across any other platform that you have. But if you're sticking towards the Apple ecosystem, you can still use OneNote, but now you have a handful of other applications that you can use. And GoodNotes 6 is one of those. GoodNotes 6 is a really powerful, really renowned application, and it uses a PDF planner to be able to allow you to plan. So what is a PDF planner? Let's ask that question first. A PDF planner is a PDF interactive planner. What that means is the interactive portion of it allows you to navigate throughout the planner using hyperlinks. With GoodNotes 6, a lot of the PDF annotation apps like GoodNotes 6 is allowing you to create your own hyperlinks. And where this is really cool is you can link your notes, like say for example, you have a meeting page and you want to link that to your daily page for the scheduled meeting. You can do that. You can also cross-reference notes. And we have an entire video right here that really deep dives into GoodNotes 6. Matter of fact, as we're talking about all these different applications, you're gonna wanna go ahead and subscribe to our channel, and you're gonna wanna check out the description, because in the description we have how-to videos on how to use each one of these applications. And I'm gonna tell you this right now, as a little behind the scenes, if you're not sure which application to use, send us a message. Say, hey Brandon, I love your planner. I wanna use it on the iPad, but I'm not sure which application to use. I'm kinda stuck between OneNote, GoodNotes, and NoteShelf. I'm gonna tell you this, buy our OneNote planner and we will gift you the other PDF editions so that you can try it out and then make a decision for yourself which application is best for you. Another application is Nobility. Now, Nobility and NoteShelf, definitely sought after applications. They work really well. They're just not as commonly known in the planning space as GoodNotes 6, but they have the same features that GoodNotes has to offer. And if you're someone that wants to experiment between the different note-taking applications, really the main difference is where the toolbars are lined up and how each application has presets for the tools that they have. Some use eraser tools differently than others, and some have different pen tools. Some have the ability to do calligraphy, and some have the ability to use like marker or sketch pencils when it comes to planning. And that's just something you're gonna have to play with a little bit to determine which application is best for you. But all of these applications have one powerful feature that I think is really important when it comes to digital planning, and that is the ability to back up. You can back up your planner to the cloud. So that way, if the device ever breaks or the app ever crashes on you and you need to restore, you can do that and you can download your notes. So you can be rest assured for not only this year, but many years to come, you have a backup for your notes. So that is a look at different applications. And you can learn more about those applications on our YouTube channel to learn how to use each independently. So as you make a decision to decide which planner you're going to use with your iPad and which application is going to be best for you, the next thing to consider, is there any accessories that I might want to utilize in planning? The thing that most commonly comes up when it comes to planning is I want a paper-like experience, right? You want to be able to feel like you're writing on paper. And generally speaking, when I pull out this iPad, there is like this gloss on it. And when I take this pencil and I start to write on the screen, it has a very plastic-like feel on glass. It doesn't feel like it's paper. Well, that's what's really cool about using some different accessories. And one of them that I highly recommend is this mat. Now, this mat does a number of things. One, you'll notice when I put it over top of the iPad itself, it kind of takes away some of that glare. But this mat is magnetic. And what makes this really cool is if you are looking to do a lot of media consumption and you want to have that high contrast that's available on the tablet itself, you can do that. But with literally a matter of a second or two, I can pop this screen cover in. It kind of creates like a vacuum seal. And now I have that screen cover on here. And with the use of the Apple Pencil, I now have a more paper-like experience. And take it even a step further, the vendor that I recommend has a number of different tips. And one of these tips is this metal tip. And this really gets refined. As I write with this tip, it has the friction that gives not only a sense of writing on paper, but I can also hear the sound of friction taking place. And that's really exciting. That's almost like pleasing to the mind as I go about planning. So when it comes to thinking about accessories, that's one thing I'd highly recommend doing is looking at some type of paper-like screen cover. This one here, I really recommend. It's in the description. You can learn all about it. There's even a savings opportunity for you. But it's the one out of all of them that I tried that I liked the best. The other accessories you might want to consider is, do you want some type of keyboard? Now, I've used a number of different keyboards. Ones that really stand out to me is this Logitech keyboard. It easily just kind of pops on the device like this. It acts as a cover, but I can then also flip open the back of the cover here and create like a standing feel, and it allows me to then go ahead and type as I'd like. Also, I can take this keyboard cover off, and with this stand, I can kind of create the iPad at an elevated or slanted position, and that just seems to be a little more pleasing. Apple also offers a keyboard, a Magic Keyboard. They also have a Folio keyboard, so some things you might want to consider. But as you can see here, when I take this iPad and put it on this keyboard, I now have not only a case and a cover, but I also have the ability to have some type of keyboard that I can type in. And we talk about typing in a planner. Is that possible? Yes, with the iPad and all the apps I've talked about today, you can definitely type in them. So you have the benefit of going from typing to handwriting. I always default towards handwriting, but in cases I'm writing out an email or dictating notes, it's really convenient to be able to type. And as I showed you, there's many opportunities where you can take your handwritten notes and convert those to type so that you can use that text in those same type of annotations and emails, or even if you're looking to share those notes with other people. As I dive into these tech reviews and talk about and introduce new products, one thing that's constantly on my mind is cable management. And a lot of times if I'm on the go, I'm thinking, do I need to bring this cable, that cable? And quite honestly, I don't want to have a half a dozen cables for all the different things that I have, from charging my device to transferring data to be able to connect the different peripherals. Let me introduce to you a 4-in-1 cable by xCool. With these cables, not only do you have a lightning port, but you have a USB-C adapter, a USB-A, as well as a USB-C, and it's 100 watts. So you can power your laptop, you can power your tablets, and you can even power your phones. You can also transfer data across these because the speed is incredible. Now, the quality of these builds is pretty amazing. They come in different colors, but they have a braided feel and they're flat finish. So I can easily roll these up, put them in my bag, stuff them in my backpack, or even slip them in amongst my gear. And no matter wherever I go, no matter if I'm plugging into a USB-C port or plugging into USB-A port, if I have an old generation iPhone or a new generation iPad, or I have a tablet of another manufacturer, I can easily go ahead and charge it with these cables all in one. In the description, you can find a link to this product as well as an opportunity to save. So when we look at the iPad, again, things to consider is what iPad do I want to use? And I want to think through the size of the screen, the storage, as well as the processing speed. I want to think about the app that I want to use, and then consider any accessories that I might need. The last thing, let's just talk about planners in general. Now, obviously, you're listening to me, Brandon Bonhoeffer, creator and founder of the Key to Success Planner. I encourage you to take a few minutes, check out our planning system. You're also going to be able to find planners on the web throughout various places. And really what makes our planner unique is, one, we're providing training. We provide tons of free training across our channel. We train on how to use the planning system. We train how to use the applications as well as the devices. It's kind of a complete ecosystem. And our planners are designed for personal, professional, and business development. And the tools are just that. They are a system of tools that help you take your visionary thoughts and ideas and help you garner real action steps that you can do each day throughout your daily planning. Now, other planning systems out there have tools, they have templates, but I haven't personally seen one that has a complete ecosystem as well as online chat and email support. So if you got questions, go ahead, check out our website, start a chat with us. If it be choosing which device to use or which planner best fits your needs, we're here to help you. I'm excited that you're taking this step, because when we dive into digital planning, especially with an iPad, there's so many things that you're going to find a benefit in. The ability to boost your memory and boost your creativity and harness all your thoughts and ideas, being able to synchronize those notes across different devices, and the ability to search your handwritten notes is just some of the small benefits that digital planning has to offer. If you guys learned just one thing in this video, do me a favor. Hit the like button so others can learn and see the actions. Subscribe to our channel if you're interested in learning more about this content. And by all means, if you got questions, go ahead, hit the comments. Somebody, my team or myself, will answer them for you. And Lord willing, guys, I hope to see you in an upcoming video real soon. God bless each and every one of you. And what you see the iPad Pro is. Matter of fact,